Isang mapagpala at magandang araw pong muli sa inyong lahat. Pagbati po sa inyong misyonero dito po sa Alberta, Canada. And for our 7-minute prayer devotion this morning, I'd like to invite you to the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 1. 2 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 22. The Bible says, "Who hath also sealed us and given the earnest of the Spirit in our hearts." God pictures salvation in many different ways, so that any person who wants to get saved will understand what they must do to be saved. For instance, salvation is a judicial transaction. God pronounces the sinner guilty and sentences them to death, a death in hell. However, Jesus Christ comes into the courtroom of eternity and offers his sacrificial death on the cross to pay for the sins of the sinner. All the sinner must do is accept Christ's payment and they will be saved, and their record will show their debt to God has been paid. Salvation is also a transaction of property. God makes the offer to purchase the sinner with the blood of Jesus Christ. The sinner must accept this offer if they want to be saved. The moment the sinner accepts this offer to be purchased with Christ's blood, God puts his earnest down, and that earnest is the Holy Spirit of God. In our devotion this morning, we can see here that in both of these instances, one of the greatest things that happens is that God seals our salvation. Sabi po muli dito ng Biblia, "Who hath also sealed us." Ano po ang panselyo ng Diyos? Walang iba kundi ang Espiritu ng Diyos sa ating mga puso. So ang mensahe po ngayong umaga is entitled, Sealed. Sealed. Sinelyohan. So the seal was often the stamp of the king's ring on a law to show that the law enacted could never be changed. When a sinner gets saved, God puts his seal on the life of the believer to show the transaction was made, or transaction made cannot be undone. God goes even further into this transaction by putting his Holy Spirit, the Holy Spirit of God, into the heart of the believer as the earnest of this transaction. In other words, we have God's promise this transaction will be completed someday. What transaction? Ano po ba yung transaction na ito? The transaction that one day He will take us to heaven. Oh, the transaction of our sins were eternally paid when the believer accepts Christ as their Savior. But God will complete the whole transaction of bringing the believer to heaven one day. Until then, we are sealed. Tayo po ay sinelyuhan with the Holy Spirit of God. So what does it mean to be sealed by the Holy Spirit? Three things. Number one, first, it means our salvation is secured in Christ. When earnest money is put down, the earnest money is put into a secure trust account. The Holy Spirit is that earnest that secures our soul for heaven. Until we get to heaven, we have the confidence that we will go there because the Holy Spirit lives within us. Secondly, it means we are purchased. The transaction for our sin is complete. The seal of God has been placed on our lives, and He gives His seal to show others that we belong to Him. The fact God purchased you should cause you to live like you belong to God. To live for anything or anyone else other than God when you are saved, it is to use God's possession, your life, for the wrong purpose. And thirdly, it means we belong to God. The salvation transaction means we are placed into the family of God. You are part of God's family, and you should live according to the family name. I have a seal on my life. Ako po personally ay naselyohan na sa buhay ko. Mula po nung tinanggap ko ang Panginoong Hesus taong 2000 bilang sariling Panginoon at tagapagligtas. And God now has the right to tell me how to live the life because I belong to Him. You are His child, you are the child of the Father, and you should live as your Heavenly Father tells you to live in His Word. So, sealed. Huwag po nating kakalimutan. Tayo po ay manalangin. Let us bow our heads and thank the Lord for this wonderful gift of eternal life and the seal of the earnest promise of possession of heaven through the Holy Spirit of God. Let us bow our heads. Dear Heavenly Father, we are so thankful. We are so blessed, Lord, upon hearing your word, upon hearing your promise this morning. Thank you, Lord God, for this very, very relevant and important doctrine about salvation. The day we got saved, we are already sealed by the Holy Spirit of God in our hearts. Thank you, Lord God, and please bless the whole day. In Jesus' most precious name I pray. Amen. Thank you and God bless you.